concern over the closure of two official news outlets in Cebu, Sugbo TV and Sugbo News, reportedly upon the orders of Acting Governor AGNES Magpale. The NUJP cites news reports from Cebu that said Magpale ordered the uplink internet connection of the local cable television station cut and the booth padlocked to review the programs of the news outlets. The reports also claim the Sugbo TV crew was barred from continuing to cover the unfolding situation at the provincial capital where Governor Gwen Garcia remains holed up. The NUJP says the news outlets may have become casualties in the ongoing political impasse. Joining us on the line is Acting Cebu Governor AGNES Magpale. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, Ron.
Ma'am, we just want to get your the confirmation first from you that Sugbo TV and Sugbo News were closed upon your order?
Ron, let me make a clarification. I heard you earlier. They are not official outlets, Ron. Let me explain. Sugbo TV is not an independent media entity. It is an adjunct of the provincial, it is under the governor's office. Then second, Sugbo TV is just a content provider to the Sky Cable. Now, Ron, right now, the transition, I have just convened a transition committee to review all contracts and transactions entered into by the provincial government. Hello?
Yes, ma'am, I'm here. Yes, ma'am, go ahead.
Yes, and, to operate, to continue operating Sugbo TV would need us a considerable sum of money, Ron. So under review now are the functions of the 35 employees under working for Sugbo TV. But we're not terminating their contract. We're not terminating the contract with Sky Cable. As a matter of fact, I was very emphatic. We will continue paying for whatever is in the contract. But we are in the process of reviewing contracts. So by January, as a matter of fact, there is a plan to institutionalize the Sugbo TV. Mm-hmm. There's an ordinance coming up, which is already on second reading. But we need really to the chair of the committee already expressed a desire to reformat, to review, and to inventory equipment. They're quite expensive, Ron. Now, I know your concern. It's about freedom of the press. Please don't be misled by certain elements in Cebu that we are clamping down the press. Now, you have your contacts in Cebu, and I know that you can call them anytime. And I would like to repeat that the Sugbo TV is not an independent media entity.
That's right, ma'am.
Therefore, the principle of prior restraint is not really applicable here.
Okay, we were just quoting the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, who said that Sugbo TV and Sugbo News were official news stations of the government. Okay, thank you very much.
Wrong.
Thank you very much for clarifying that. But Sugbo TV and Sugbo News are also funded by the office of the governor. Is that correct?
Exactly, mm-hmm. Funded by taxpayers' money, Ron. Mm-hmm. And I have, sworn to protect and to be accountable to every centavo spent.
So, okay. And as you said, this is just up for review. The reason why you're stopping the broadcast of Sugbo TV,
yes,
and Sugbo News.
Yes, I never said, I said a temporary shutdown. When I talked to the operations manager, she was in my office Friday evening. I was very clear that we will temporarily shut off.
So you
and besides, Ron, mm-hmm. We just discovered that they don't even have an independent media franchise. I just checked. There are several things happening here in Cebu right now, but we're checking things out, and I just discovered that they don't even have an independent media franchise.
Ma'am, who started Sugbo TV and Sugbo News?
Well, this was a project of suspended Governor Gwen Garcia. Mm-hmm. And they're supposed to promote Cebu, and you know very well that we are in the thick of promotions. Mm-hmm. But is the amount. I mean, you know, like I said, we are reviewing all contracts now. We're reviewing expenses. We're trying to see where we can pare down some of the expenses to prioritize services that we need, like health, etc.
But yes, ma'am, we just want to clarify that the closure of Cebu News and Cebu TV does not have anything to do with the political impasse you have with suspended Governor Garcia.
Now, this is just one of the contracts that budget is the more important thing here, Ron. That's why when we are reviewing contracts, like I said, it's all because of the budget. Now, I want to assure you, and I want to assure our listeners there in Manila, that freedom of speech and freedom of the press is very much alive and well in Cebu.
Okay, you said, ma'am, that this contract is just up for review. The Cebu News and Cebu TV operations are just up for review. We just want to get a background. You did say that this was started by suspended Governor Garcia, but how many employees does Cebu News and Cebu TV have?
Right now, there are 35 employees. Mm-hmm. That's why I asked the operations manager to give me an executive brief by Wednesday. And tell me the job description of each and every employee. Mm-hmm. 35, that's the number.
And you did say that you are planning to institutionalize the two stations. Does it mean you're going to make it official, or there is a proposal to make these stations official already?
Yes, the move came from the legislative department. As a matter of fact, there's a provincial board member who sponsored this ordinance institutionalizing both the Cebu TV and the Cebu, we call that Cebu News.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But he had several public hearings, and what came out was, of course, the need to have a policy on as to content, that format, that it should solely be used to promote Cebu.
Okay, thank you very much for clarifying that issue, ma'am. Now, on to another topic. Governor Gwen Garcia just said that she is still not going to be leaving the capital and is going to be staying there for Christmas and maybe a few days after until she gets a decision from the Court of Appeals. Your reaction to that, ma'am?
For as long as I'm not being bothered. Right now, I'm still focused on what I really have to do.
Mm-hmm.
But if her continued presence will impede the delivery of basic services and it will cause the breakdown of peace and order in the province, then of course, I know that there are proper entities right now working together, trying to find ways and means to, you know, solve this problem.
Okay, there have been allegations that the police, upon your orders, have been stopping the supporters of suspended Governor Garcia from entering the capital. Is that correct, ma'am?
That's not correct, Ron. What the police have done, as a matter of fact, I would like to congratulate General Garbo and Region 7, PNP Region 7, because they have really maintained peace and order in spite of what's going on here. Well, these are tactical maneuvers of the police. Like, I know what you're referring to, the requirement of IDs. Now, Ron, I have this obligation, I have this mandate to take care of the capital, its premises, and to maintain peace and order.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if the requirement of having an ID, an identification, that came from the police, and let's help them. I pity these policemen. They're still here, and it's going to be, I'm here too, but this is almost Christmas Eve.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We are now on holiday break. During the past several days, people were really free to come in and out. Now, we are on holiday break. I don't think there's anybody who would want to come in to do business at the Capitol. So, like again, temporarily, during the holidays, there's need to check on what why they are coming in. So mm-hmm. I understand because my daughter, My own daughter had to leave her ID when she came here this morning to visit me. Mm-hmm. My own lawyer, who also came because I heard that charges will be filed against me on Wednesday. They also had to leave their IDs. Now, she is now receiving her friends, her relatives. They're all allowed to come in, but of course, subject to proper identification. Remember, there are I am tasked to take care of the buildings, the equipment here, right here at the Capitol, and it's quite difficult. I'm in a predicament. I'm here, but I have to. I know I should be. I will be answering questions like what you have now.
Ma'am. But yeah, go ahead.
There is the balance I have to make. My duty as now the acting governor.
Ma'am, you mentioned something about charges that are going to be filed against you on Wednesday.
I heard. This is what I heard from our local media outlets.
What kind of charges, ma'am?
I think it has something to do with the temporary shut off. I'm not really sure now. That's right.
Okay, we'll try to double check that issue. One more question, ma'am. One more issue. Just this weekend, suspended Governor Garcia had a number of visitors. Among them, you can call political heavyweights, former President Estrada, Vice President Binay, and Senate President Enrile. Your reaction to those to that visit, ma'am?
Well, I was expecting that, Ron. As a matter of fact, I thought they would come on the first day. I'm sure the suspended governor Garcia has many friends from the national scene. In fact, maybe if GMA were well today, she would be here. She's a good friend of suspended governor Gwen Garcia. I would have expected GMA to come.
And you were not threatened by the visits, ma'am?
No, Ron. I was here. And by the way, I was conducting a meeting. I was presiding over a meeting of the provincial disaster DRRMC, the risk and management, because there was a threat of a typhoon. I was in the legislative building holding my meeting when the three gentlemen came. Mm-hmm. Why should I be threatened, Ron?
Okay, Acting Cebu Governor AGNES Magpale, ma'am, thank you very much for clarifying those issues and giving us your reactions to the different issues there. Thank you very much, ma'am, and Merry Christmas.
And thank you very much. Merry Christmas, too.
More news. Disaster officials are calling on residents of Compostela Valley and Davao Oriental to brace for a new low-pressure area that could spawn rains and trigger flash floods and landslides.